And we're going to need everybody's help singing with us on the chorus. We'll sing it one time so you can hear how it goes, and then you can join in.
This is very much an Earth Day song. It's about taking care of the world. That's what Earth Day is all about, just like you guys are doing today. So here's how the chorus goes.
Changes, we can make them if we choose to. It's up to me and you. Oh, changes, changes, we can make them if we choose to.
Okay. All right, y'all ready? Here we go.
Many, many years ago, when the Great Spirit breathed upon the water and brought life, all the people were happy because there was clean air, clean water, plenty of food to eat. They worked and they played in harmony with nature, and everybody was happy. But down through the centuries, things changed. Little villages became huge cities with skyscrapers. And then the people got greedy. They wanted more than their fair share. They destroyed the water and the air, and they fought with one another, and they moved away from one another, and they became isolated from one another. They were no longer happy. And then one day it happened. The butterflies. Now this was sad because butterflies were sacred. Butterflies represented beauty and change. And everybody marveled at the way a caterpillar could transform itself. Reminding us we could change if we wanted to. But everything seemed helpless now that the butterflies are out.
Thank you so much.
Changes, we can make them if we choose to. It's up to me. Oh, 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 changes, changes, we can make them if we choose to.
So the Great Spirit was worried about his children, so he devised a plan. He sent children out to every corner of the globe, and he told them each to bring back something incredibly beautiful.
So from the tundra of Antarctica, this is what they brought.
A million sparkling crystals made out of thin ice, garment brightly woven from the northern lights, tusk of a woolly mammoth and the wild winds that wail, a snow queen dressed in moonbeams with her long white feather veil.
And from the Orient and from the Far East, this is what they brought.
A wooden pagoda carved entirely by hand, a million yards of the finest silk and a tiny paper fan. A little green Siamese cat sculpted out of jade, and a thousand perfectly folded origami cranes.
Changes, we can make them if we choose to. It's up to me and you. Oh, changes.
So, the Great Spirit took out a sack that was made of wishes and dreams. Inside it, he put all these beautiful things.
So, from the Americas and the Wild West, this is what they brought.
Mainly scented sage, corky pine quills, buffalo hide, soapstone pipe, painted desert hills, an Appaloosa pony just as swift as the wind, and a medicine bag best ever made.
And from Africa, and from South America, this is what they brought.
A red tailed feather from a parakeet, shiny green leaf from the great coconut tree, the pyramids of Giza, the whole River Nile, zebra stripes, leopard spots, and a crocodile smile.
Yo, changes, we can make them if we choose to. It's up to me and you.
Now, even with all that magic, the Great Spirit needed more magic. He needed stronger magic. So he cut off a lock of hair from children everywhere, every race, every beautiful face, red and yellow, black and white, gold and brown and tan. He gathered gathered all those locks of hair into his hand, and he put them in the sack, and he tied it up real tight, and he sprinkled it with stardust from the darkest night. Then he made a wish. He wished we could work together again, that we could tolerate one another and learn to be friends. Then he said the magic words,
please and thank you.
And he swung that sack around his head like a cowboy with a lasso. Then he set it down, opened it up, and a billion beautiful butterflies flew out, and they fluttered in the wind, and the people, they were happy once again.
Changes, we can make them if we choose to, it's up to you. Oh, changes, changes, we can make them if we choose to.
Trying to build a food forest and a farm park. We work with food insecurity issues and do environmental issues of diverting food waste from Whole Foods and Ozark Natural Foods and then several other companies. And we prioritize people first, animals second, and then compost to make it soil third. And last year we delivered 99,200 pounds of food to 15 organizations that are serving families, homeless folks, and veterans, and it's like, yeah, it feels good to like do this. I mean, it's like, you know, it's like it's hard to say thank you when it's like thank you for letting us do this, and so it's been a really life-changing experience, and we invite people to come and learn about how to grow food again and how to like really connect with like how important food is to our future and our environment.
I got to go with my grandchildren to Leverett and do it.
Yeah? When the Leverett walked down, Leverett School walked to...
I'm really inspired. I'm just composting.
You mean food doesn't just come from the grocery store?
It does not, but we have been raised in a grocery store. And I think that food is just amazing. You know, I mean, we can all eat gourmet and grow gourmet, I guess. It's not really gourmet anymore. It's just food.
Well, this is for you.
Thank you.
Today I went to the grocery. It was overwhelming. Rows and rows of vegetables lined up like a rainbow.
Red cherries, blackberries, orange peppers, yellow squash.
My basket's full of lovely greens, all sorts of exotic things that we can't grow. I grab a ripe tomato, put it in my little basket, several weeks ago, down in Mexico. I got a hankering to plant some peas, grow some spinach and broccoli. I want to get down, dig in the dirt. I want to sweat and I want to work.
Grow sweet corn, 10 feet tall, live outside from summer to fall. I want to go garden. I want to go garden, all that entails. I want to get some dirt down under
my nails. Today I went to the grocery. It was overwhelming. Rows and rows of vegetables lined up like a rainbow.
Asparagus tender and green, out of season. I can't
get to know the worms, learn to preserve like my grandma did. So in the winter we'll all be fed. Reap the harvest when it comes in.
Never have to shop at Walmart again. I want to go garden. I want to go garden, all in a tears. I want to get some dirt down under my for not writing for so long. I must admit, something in America is wrong. I just want to apologize. I wish it could be otherwise. It's something that we both despise. That's been weighing on my mind for so long. The rulers here act as if they're gods of all the earth. They trifle with the lives of people in ambitious mirth. Please realize that they aren't me. They are blind, but I can see. Their grotesque barbarity. Their friends, the rulers, know not what it's worth. It ain't me, foreign friend, it ain't me.
I do not now and never did support the sickening evil that you see on your TV. The rulers are not me. The soldiers are not me. The government's not me. I renounce them, I denounce them, I condemn them through and through. I swear I won't forgive them for the evil that they do. Dear barn friend, it ain't me. Oh, no, no, it ain't me. The ruling caste holds itself above the moral plane. The government shoots the poor and drops the bombs like rain. I just want to apologize. I wish it could be otherwise. It's something that we both despise. Dear friend, I know not how to stop the pain. But it ain't me, barn friend. It ain't me. I do not now and never did support the sickening evil that you see on your TV. The rulers are not me. The soldiers are not me. The government's not me. I renounce them, I denounce them, I condemn them through and through. I swear I won't forgive them for the evil that they do. Dear barn friend, it ain't me. Oh, no, no, it ain't me. Sincerely yours, I write as one disgusted by all men that glorify mass murder as a contest one can win. Please realize that they aren't me. They are blind, but I can see their grotesque barbarity. I hold that all humanity is good. So it ain't me, barring friend, it ain't me. I do not now and never did support the sickening evil that you see on your TV. The rulers are not me. The soldiers are not me. The government's not me. I renounce them, I denounce them, I condemn them through and through. I swear I won't forgive them for the evil that they do. Dear barn friend, it ain't me. No, 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 it ain't me.
HLM, je te dédicace ce poème en espérant qu'au fond de tes yeux ternes tu puisses y voir un petit brin d'herbe. Et les mannes, faut faire la part des choses. Il est grand temps de faire une pause, troquer cette primose contre le parfum d'une rose. L'hymne de nos campagnes, de nos rivières, de nos montagnes, de la vie man, du monde animal. Fort rustique en de vocal. Pas de boulot, pas de diplôme. Partout la même odeur de zone. Plus rien n'agite tes neurones. Pas même le shit que tu mets dans tes cônes. Va voir ailleurs, rien ne te retient. Va vite faire quelque chose. Tes mains ne te retournent pas. Et si tu n'as rien, et sois le premier à chanter ce refrain. C'est l'hymne de nos campagnes, de nos rivières, de nos montagnes, de la vie man, du monde animal. Bien fort, ruse tes cordes vocales. Assieds-toi près d'une rivière. Écoute le coulis de l'eau sur la terre. Dis-toi qu'au bout, hey, il y a la mer. Et que ça, ça n'a rien d'éphémère. Tu comprendras alors que tu n'es rien. Comme celui avant toi, comme pour celui qui vient. Que le liquide qui coule dans tes mains te servira à vivre jusqu'à demain matin.
Thank you.
humoristes et cordes vocales. Peut-être que je parle pour ne rien dire, mais quand tu m'écoutes, tu as envie de rire. Et c'est le béton et ton avenir. Dis-toi que c'est la forêt qui fait que tu respires, respires. J'aimerais pour tous les animaux que tu captes le message de mes mots. Car le pain de terre, une tige de roseau, c'est rire à la croissance de tes mamans. C'est rire à la croissance de tes mamans. C'est l'hymne de nos campagnes, de nos rivières, de nos montagnes, de la vie même, du monde animal. Une lumière foruste et corde vocale.
Hungry child, this world was not made for you. You didn't buy shares in my railroad. You didn't invest in my corporation. And where are your stocks in Standard Oil?
Pas loin et tu sais lui parler.